to Fika for Life. My name is Edward Thomas, and my co-host is
Lynn Nguyen. Hello, everyone.
Hello, Lynn. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm better.
Wow, you win. So we were just talking about what we should talk about.
Yeah, which
today.
We don't usually know until we start opening our mouths.
Blah, and then blah, blah.
The wisdom just pours out. So.
So yesterday I watched with some friends the Disney movie Soul.
Yes.
And you said you watched it too last
year.
I'm a bit behind.
Oh yeah, but that means your memory of the movie is like fresher.
Yeah. I feel it's a really nice movie.
Yeah.
But I think what I want to talk about today with our listeners was because a main topic in the movie is about passion and purpose. So the question they are trying to
work out.
Discuss in the movie is like, is passion your purpose in life? Or is it different? Is passion not your purpose? I think the movie says that passion is not necessarily your purpose. What do you think?
I think it says that passion is whatever I'm passionate about.
Okay. Like, okay, Mr. Obvious.
Yo.
Captain Obvious.
Nay, but I think that was like the interesting part of it was that he finally gets his big break and everything.
Yeah.
And then he dies.
Ooh.
And the thing is that he never really thought about his life seriously until he dies.
Yeah, he thought that.
You know, like he thought he was gonna work towards getting his
thing. We're spoiling this now.
If you haven't seen it, haha.
We're spoiling it now. So, like he is really a jazz enthusiast, and he wanted to do jazz all his life, but he ends up being a teacher, which is not what he wants. And then he's offered a full time position, and then his mom, everyone around, oh, it's so good, you have social security and blah blah blah.
Yeah.
But he's like,
he wanted to be a professional jazz musician.
This was not what he wanted. He wanted to be a jazz musician. Mm. So he gets this amazing opportunity to play a really famous one, and it's maybe this time of breakthrough. But then he just
falls into a manhole.
Dies.
And dies.
So on the way for him to go into his bright light, he realized, no, I'm not going to die. So he tries to find a way back.
Right.
And he's running, and then somehow he, instead of going back to Earth straight away, he happens to be in some middle ground where new souls prepare to go to Earth.
Yeah.
And there he meets.
Which is really weird because that's like a Mormon concept of the preexistence of the soul. And so that your soul is waiting for its body up in heaven.
To go.
Yeah, I was like, okay.
Well, that's really interesting.
I'm like, Disney, you're like all into the really weird, freaky stuff now.
Yeah, there's some new age stuff in there.
Yeah, I
know. It's also really
metaphysical.
Creepy.
Like, well, okay. I don't know. but that wasn't the point. The point isn't to analyze it from a religious perspective. The point that we wanted to bring up is to talk about this whole idea of passion
and
versus
purpose. Yeah.
Which I think is kind of hard because sometimes it does feel like they're the same thing. Or maybe it feels like my purpose changes every so often.
Passions usually don't.
No.
They maybe change in intensity.
Chocolate, I'm always passionate about. Always. And I sometimes think my purpose is to eat as much chocolate as I can in 1 year.
Well, you are as chocolatey as it gets.
I'm rolling in it. I'm chocolate on the inside and the outside.
Like. You're breathing chocolate.
Yeah, I mean, it's coming out of me, out of my pores.
Oh,
someone licks my pores, they're going to get chocolate.
Nasty.
Like, oh, it's just like Willy Wonka.
But what would you say is your purpose?
To be your friend and lead you on the path of righteousness.
Oh, wow.
I know, it's a big job.
You're not doing a good job.
I think I'm doing an excellent job for the material I have to work with.
Ooh, the material is limiting.
Yes, it is. It's very resistant to change.
I don't know what my passion is.
You don't? I mean, you're passionate about kids. You're passionate about telling me what to do.
Maybe my passion is to telling people what to do.
I think so. I think that your passion is to boss
telling
people around.
People what to, my parents always taught me I should go into management. I should have.
You probably should have. You would have been a good manager. Everybody would have been afraid of you. They're like, oh my gosh, Lynn's coming, clean up, wait, I'm just going to bite you.
I want people to respect me, not to fear
me. I respect you. I'm just afraid of you more than I respect you. That's all. being afraid of you brings respect to me. I feel like, okay, let me generate respect now.
But I guess so I can both live. Things you're going to earn, fear and respect.
Oh, hey. Whatever you say.
And then yes, I would say, well, I can't help people if they can't decide what to drink.
Exactly.
Respect or fear.
Smack. But you said you didn't know what your purpose is.
No, I said I didn't know what my passion is.
Okay, I didn't hear you really well. I'm sorry. I was just...
So your passion definitely is not listening.
No, I hate to listen. I like to talk. Yeah, haven't you noticed that by now? Why do you think you don't know what your purpose is?
I said, I don't think I know what my passion is.
I think I have Alzheimer's. I think this is the proof now. Listen to everyone. You're hearing it right now. Breaking news.
I have passion and purpose.
Okay, well, let me try this one more time. So, your passion is. And what was your purpose?
We're talking about that. I said that I don't think I know really what my passion is because.
But you're like a really passionate person.
What you mean?
I don't know. I just thought I would say that sounded really good. In my head, I was like, I should say
that. You mean I just have a little feelings that just come out, pour out, both good and bad.
Oh my gosh. It's like.
It's temperance.
It's like a fountain, but you're just always guessing what comes out.
It could be beer. It could be wine. It could also be poop.
Exactly. You're just hoping this time it'll be something good.
Even you if drink it's from too that warm. Fountain, it could be the best day of your life or the worst.
Oh my gosh, what kind of mood is she in today?
No. Hey, I'm not that unpredictable though.
No, I know. All you have to do is just disagree with you, and you're just like,
hey, I'm no, you're painting okay, as such a you're horrible not. Witch not, who cannot like handle.
You can't handle someone telling you no. Like, no, Lynn, no, I can't talk to you today. What the hell are you talking about, guys?
I would never say that to you. No, you know that. I don't swear at you like that at all.
No, we actually, you're a really nice person. Mm. But I like to tease you a lot because you're like my little sister.
Well, you just told me about your little sister, and I'm like, okay, well, I guess, that's not a compliment.
Well, you don't want to be like that one. That's why you're not related to me. Maybe it's genetic. I don't know.
Okay, let's get back to what's your passion?
I don't know if I have a passion. Okay,
but yes, you said
okay.
Cooking.
Yeah, okay, I know. I was just about to say that I was gonna come there, but now you just outed me.
You like food, man.
I love food. Oh my gosh,
that's your passion.
Yeah, I mean, my problem is I have too many passions.
How can you have too many passions?
Because I want to do them all at the same time.
Like gardening.
Yes,
you really like gardening.
How do you know these things about me? Have I ever talked to you about...
All our listeners know about your passions by now,
my
please.
My passion is to spread the cult of bokashi around the world.
Yeah, bokashi.
So I love gardening. I love, like, I'm really passionate about gardening. Mm-hmm. And I'm very passionate about making food.
You're passionate about youth work.
Yeah.
Working with young people.
Yes, I am. In the context of... on a journey with them and sharing faith.
Music.
Oh, I'm passionate about God. Mm. God is like, probably my biggest passion is God. Because that sort of touches everything else.
Yeah, I was thinking like,
you know, I grow the food so that.
God provides.
Because God is blessing me on the earth. And then I sing the music to praise his name.
Okay. Wow.
I know. I'm in the bubble, people.
You're in the bubble.
I only speak church talk, you know.
Churchy. Christianese.
People come to my house and I'm like, they're like, how is Edward talking about this? Oh, yeah, a servant of the Lord right here, saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost.
It's okay because you're American. You can get away with it.
I know, exactly. People are like, Americans are stupid anyway. So it's like, And to my fellow Americans, I don't think that Americans are stupid, but people think that we are. So we have to deal with that, okay? We have to own that one.
Like, okay, I will live up to it.
Exactly. I'm going to prove you right. No, but yeah, so those are probably some of the things that I'm passionate about reading. Like, I have over 3,000 books.
Good for you.
I love books. I love to read. Oh my gosh. That is a big passion that sometimes life gets in the way and I can't read as much as I want. So I'm still, like this year I thought I would read like 35 books and I'm still only on 15 to 20 books this year.
Dude.
So I feel like a loser. I feel like I'm not reading enough.
Wow. You read way more than I do.
Yeah, I read more than many people that I know.
And you always say you don't have time. You do have time.
Yeah,
apparently.
But I read like when I sit on the toilet. I do a lot of reading when I'm pooping.
Yeah, you poop a lot. Apparently.
I know. Well, it does.
Well, I have small children, so I only read kids' books. And then I read also a lot.
Oh, yeah, exactly. The house is green, the trees are blue.
Yeah.
Hey, the sky is red.
It's not about quality. It's about quantity. Okay? I read a lot of books.
But it's kind of weird when you say you don't have any... you're passionate about your kids.
What do you mean passion? They are my responsibility. It's not like...
No, but they're your...
What is passion then?
How many times have you said, Ty's so cute! That's passion.
That's not passion.
That's the same way I talk about chocolate. I'm like,
it's so good.
I'm like, oh my gosh, this chocolate bar. I mean, it really fulfills me with like, as well as I'm eating this thing, I feel like, oh, this is what I was created for.
But okay, what would you say is passion? According to you, what is passion?
The thing that makes you get out of the bed. When you feel like
I'm really passionate about money because I go to my work and it's like, oh, I have to go.
No, I go to my work because I need money. If I didn't need money, I wouldn't go.
Yeah, but then you're passionate because you said the things that make you get out of bed.
The things that make you, when you want to get out of bed, not like make you get out of bed in the sense that, all right, if I don't do this thing, I'll be living in a cardboard box outside.
I like to socialize.
Maybe you are passionate about people.
But people are dumb. Sorry, guys. Wow. Don't take it personal.
Let's take that one away. Sorry, you're not passionate about people. Maybe that's your purpose.
It's my purpose.
Yeah, maybe your purpose is to be used by God to help as many people as possible.
I don't know if I'm always helping them, but I think...
You try to. I know you mean well, even all the people who run away and like, I'm never going to talk, I'm going to live in the woods.
No, but I really think that that's something as like a gift, because a lot of people have commented on that and they say that I'm really special in that way with people. And I always wondered like, maybe
what
did
they
gift.
Say about you?
What?
What did they say about you?
They say that...
That you're special?
Not negative. maybe they mean that. No, they don't. No, they like, don't.
You're really special.
Oh no, God, no, no, save no, me, no, no, no. They say that I'm special in a way that I really seem to care. I seem to connect with people. Yeah. It comes really natural to me to just meet people and connect to them and make them feel welcome and make them feel like, hey, I'm interested in you as a person, and I can connect with you, and it's easy to talk to me, and blah, 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 blah. See?
That sounds so nice.
But that's something like, I don't really have to put an effort into it, you know? I know a lot of people, they really have to, like, practice, or if you really
awkward.
They
have to try to like people.
No, they have to really try to make an effort, but for me, it just comes naturally. I can't help it. Like,
But I think, like, I mean, another thing that I've noticed through the years is that you're really like you and Eunice, you guys always open your home up to other people.
Because we don't have anything valuable there.
Right. People can't steal anything. It's like, whatever.
Yeah, it's like,
let them take
has
it.
Has no value.
We got it at Lopez last week for 5 crowns. No, but I think that's one of the things actually I admire both of you guys is that you're able to open your home up. And I've seen this several times, when people come to your guys' house, they always feel welcome. Doesn't matter what combination of people it is, how old or how young they are. No, but it's that might be, it could be either your purpose or your passion. I don't know. Maybe it's not the thing that makes you get up in the morning, oh, great, we can have people over.
No, but sometimes I just feel like, oh.
But you do it so often.
I think it's more my purpose then.
Yeah.
I think it's my purpose.
Yeah, maybe your purpose is to, because one of the things like, so you like to play matchmaker. That's bringing people together.
Yeah, but it hasn't been really successful. I'm so sorry.
Well, that doesn't matter. You still like to do
it. It's really fun,
It's really fun to mess over people's lives and their heart.
I'm just giving them a
games. Yeah, exactly. And then when you're having people over at your house, whether it's a game night or whether it's for food or something, you're bringing people together.
Yeah.
And I see that even at church, you know, that a lot of people come, even I'm the pastor, I think more people come and talk to you than they ever come and talk to me. Most people are just like...
they come to you like, Pastor, please pray for me. Can you pray for me?
I know. A like, function. Not me. They don't want anything from me. They're just saying like, oh, he's a pastor. Maybe he's close to God. Okay, pray for me, please. Maybe something better will happen. I'm like, whoa, you really picked the wrong pastor. You can pick one of those powerful guys where they bathe in the water. You drink their water so they get their anointing.
Please don't talk about it, so disgusting.
And I wonder, you know what I thought about that when I read that? I was wondering, did he have underwear on when he bathed in the
water? No, of course not.
He's probably naked in there. And then people are coming there. Yeah, what's that? That toe butt water. Ooh.
No, please.
Oh, I feel the anointing right now. I feel like, oh, I'm on fire. Ooh.
Yeah, because you get diarrhea. That's why you're on
fire. It burns all the way down.
Your butt is on fire.
And to those of you who drank the water, you sucker. Golly. I don't know why you did that. That was just really stupid.
Your butt is on fire. That's
I
right.
hope so. Teach you a lesson.
Wow, that was God's love right there.
It was all Ed. Love. I'm saying this as someone who loves you. Sucker. Okay.
Wow. No, maybe that's sorry. Your purpose.
Maybe that's my purpose is to call people suckers.
Yeah.
Suckers.
No, what would you say is your purpose then? Because you have so many passions.
Oh, wow. Yeah, and that's true. I have a lot of passions, a lot of interests, and a lot of activities. And my purpose is probably really... I don't know if I've ever thought about my... I mean, I feel like my main purpose is really to build community around Jesus. I know this sounds really churchy, cliche.
But you are like
But that is really... Like when I wake up in the morning, I think of how many people could I help... to get to know God, how many people can I journey with? Mm-hmm. Like, how can I get as many people as possible to take this journey together? That's, like, I mean, and I don't feel like I'm done yet on Earth.
Like a train conductor.
Because I feel, yeah.
Let's like, get on this train, on board. Where's your ticket? Where's your Jesus ticket?
You don't need no ticket. Just get on board. Because there's a train coming.
To take you on this ride.
Hey, we're getting there right now.
Because Jesus has paid for your ticket.
Exactly. Just punch it in. No, but I think that's, I mean, because I think in everything I've done in my whole life has always been to serve other people. It's really weird. I'm really like service-minded because I really want people to be, like, not happy, like, oh, I made people happy, I feel better. I'm just happy that people are happy. Like, I don't even have to be the one to make them happy, or they don't have to know it's me, they don't have to thank me for anything. But I really do, I really love seeing people, like, progress and grow, develop, and be happy. I think it's a really good thing.
Just being happy?
I don't know. I mean, I wouldn't say happy, like, because everything works out right.
Yeah,
maybe it's more joy, but to put in the positive energy vibes of the chakra-aligned universe.
Hey, no, you're in the wrong line of thought.
No, but I do. I mean, I really, like, I think about, like, when I was a softball coach, mm-hmm. I wanted my team to win, of course, but I really wanted them to be happy as a team. Or when I've worked with a youth, most of the kids that I've ever met, you know, at church never became Christians or anything like that.
Yeah.
But they were happy for being here, or they felt like...
they
like
got
sometimes,
something.
Yeah, like some of the kids are saying, you know, when we... Like, we always knew we can come to the church, and instead of hanging out with people who are getting drunk or whatever, we know that you would let us into the church, and we could come in and get, like, a sandwich and get some hot chocolate or something and just have a good conversation. Mm. And for me, that was like... I mean, I think one year I worked 800 hours overtime.
Woo!
But it didn't seem like I didn't feel like I was getting burnt out. I didn't feel like anything like that, because I felt like there were so many people to help and the need was so great, and I felt
you
like
you wanted to do it.
Yeah, like I really want. And whenever I got up in the morning, I was like really
excited.
like I'm like, yes, God, one more day. All right, we're gonna do this thing, you know. And I think that like so working with people, working with youth, and even as a chef, you know, I got to see people. I like making food. I like to eat food. But I really like making food for other people.
So you can see them be joyous.
Yeah, because food changes. Food can make a difference in people's lives and stuff. So
a lot.
So I think maybe that's...
Can you change my husband? Can you cook something so he will change?
Maybe. Let me work my magic. I got lots of herbs and spices. I'm like an old witch lady. I'm like, here's these That's herbs Chinese, I've been growing.
Chinese medicine Chinese for you. Medicine.
Exactly. And I stick with a big knife. It's like acupuncture. Better be nicer to Lynn.
Oh. I think I know my passion now.
Yeah. Okay. What's your passion?
To improve people. Improve things.
Yeah. Yeah. Because you don't really like people staying the same. And when mm-mm. they do stupid things, it really irritates you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If people do the same thing.
That's your holy discontent.
Again and again yeah. and again. I'm like, uh-huh. please.
Is that why
stop.
You're mad at me? Because I can't change. I just keep making the same mistake over and over
no,
again.
No. God's helping me to be more patient.
Oh, that's
why he gave it my husband. So I would understand uh-huh. what God has to stick, like,
what
understand.
What he has to stick you with.
Yeah. So to see the peeps doing all the dumb things again and again and again. No, but I really, like, I think one thing is my purpose when you say that to bring people together. Because wherever I went, didn't matter if it was for a school activity or for university or privately. Mm. I always brought people together somehow. I don't know why, but I just do. Mm. But then also to just improve, like I always, it doesn't matter if I just met people, I always need to speak some wisdom into their lives. Like if they tell me something, I'm like, this is wrong. And then I tell them, like, you know, this is not, like, you should do it like this. Even though people didn't ask me, but I was like,
I was just about to say, but people seek you out.
But they, most people do also. Yeah. But probably not people who just met me. But I'm not concerned to tell
them.
And
if you give
me
money, I'll give you an appointment with Lynn. So she likes to talk and she'll tell you what to do. She'll straighten you out. Slackers.
But I think sometimes I'm just concerned that I need more humility in that. But I get humiliated pretty often when I say dumb things.
I think it's more compassion.
Compassion gets in the way.
You have to work on your compassion.
I don't. What do you mean?
Well, after years
of therapy.
I have
passion. Yeah. I don't need compassion.
Exactly. You already have enough passion. You don't need to add any calm onto the passion. That did not sound.
Edward Lamar III.
In my mind, it sounded different. It sounded cleaner.
Anyway, I don't know. But then, what was your purpose? Was to say?
But I think also your because people seek you out to help them. But a lot of people experience you as being just really high energy and a lot of fun.
Really, yeah. I just feel I'm tired all the time.
But you fake it so well. You?
I'm tired.
Yeah. But I mean, you always ask me, "So how are you?" And I'm like, "I'm fine." And you're like, "But how are you really?"
Yeah,
and I'm like, "Oh, I'm not going to tell her. I don't want to share with anybody."
I don't want to know.
Exactly. You make me feel special. You make me feel like I'm seen and someone cares about me.
No.
I know you all hate me, so I'm going to leave next week.
No, but you know also why people feel like I see them? Because I remember things about them.
Yeah, I don't remember anything. I'm like, who are you?
Yeah, but people tell me about their part, like maybe what their kids are called or something. And then every now and then I ask them, so how's this, like, how's your grandkid or this,
really?
Their name, or how's your blah, 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 how's this or that? And then I usually remember those things.
Wow.
And then they're like,
that's commendable.
Yeah. And then I ask Jonas, you know, like, and I told you, this girl who lives with you for 3 months when I was gone. He's like, ooh. She lived with you for 3 months in the same apartment when I was gone. He's like, who? I remember. I'm like, dude.
Wow.
He would forget his own family if he wouldn't see them every day.
If he didn't write it down on a piece of paper, okay, that person is that and that person.
It's like, I take a picture. This is your daughter.
Yeah, exactly.
This is your son.
Oh, thank you. Man, y'all.
So what was your purpose again?
I have no idea. No, I think my purpose is to actually spread some kind of joy and help people on this journey.
Yeah.
I mean,
most
people,
that.
The funny thing is that people have always talked to me. So people come up and just talk to me spontaneously. Mm. I have no idea why. Like, I'm looking at my face. I'm like, I'm not that friendly looking.
There's nothing special here.
I know, exactly. It's like, ooh, wow, I wouldn't talk to you. No.
And you don't even smile when you walk around. You're just
like, I know. I walk around like all miserable, like I'm depressed. No, but I don't know why people talk to me, and I don't know why people want to hang out with me. So our friend Glenn, he says that I'm a people magnet. He's like, you just draw people. People just want to hang out with you for some reason.
Yeah, I'm why? Like, you're weird.
I don't know. Wow. Wow, if that's not the kettle calling the skillet black. Okay, well, in that case, yes,
hey.
Lynn. Yes, Lynn. The reason we are friends is because you're weird.
No, you're weird.
Listeners, you can write to us and tell us which
one
you think is
weird.
Exactly.
Yeah, tell us who's more weird.
No, but I think that if you don't do a lot of different kinds of things, you're going to have a hard time finding your passion.
True.
Because your passion is not just what you're good at, but the passion is the thing. You'll find passion because it takes time. You'll find passion because it takes energy, and you're willing to expend the energy and time for the passion.
Exactly. So you will find something that gives you joy, and then you probably stick to it and work for it. Then that's your passion. But there's a lot of things that can give you joy. Like, but then it's not, they're not all of these things will give you passion, so you are willing to put the time and effort into it.
I think I know what my passion is, though. No, my purpose.
You,
s-
you said a lot. You had a lot of passions. No, my purpose. What's the purpose?
My purpose is to lead other people.
To?
Don't matter.
To the edge of the world.
I think I'm a natural born leader, and I've always been in a position of leadership and leading people. It doesn't matter.
But that's me too. Yeah, hashtag me too.
I don't know.
Dude.
You don't lead me. I say no all the time. Okay. I'm like, Lynn, when can we do a podcast? She's like, tomorrow. Okay.
Like, yeah, tomorrow or no day. Exactly. Take it or leave it.
Take it. Okay, I'll take whatever you get me. Thank you. No, but I think, yeah, I don't think there's a specific destination for the leadership. But I tend to find myself in leadership. I mean, whether it's like, you know, being a softball trainer or a tennis trainer, whether it was working in the kitchen as a chef or working as a priest, like I always end up in leadership
over just lording over other people.
Exactly. I was born to be your dictator. That's my purpose.
Lording
if the world would just
people.
Elect me as a world leader, I'm trying to tell you, don't even worry about the Antichrist. He gets no room in. I'm much nicer. Okay.
Says the Antichrist.
Exactly. Exactly. Just to expose that again to you. No, but I think that must be my purpose is to lead. Because even when I was a kid, I was still leading. I was leading like Sunday school.
Me?
When I was a kid.
Me?
Yeah, I was just like you, but younger.
Excuse me. Well, I am actually only a baby Christian.
Yeah, okay, that's true.
I'm only 9 years Christian.
Compared to Grandpa Christian, I'm like, you know, feel the
wisdom.
I've
only been a Christian for 9 years, so.
Really? Wow.
What do I know?
Man, sometimes it's hard to believe that it's only been that short a time.
You see, I was a raw diamond even before that.
Oh, God.
My head is going to explode.
We have to grease that head just to get it, kick it out the door. It's like. Yeah, so that must be my purpose, but I think my ultimate passion.
Dude, you have so many passions. Please don't roll on the whole.
No, I can speak a whole half an hour. Let's talk about me.
My passion.
No, but I think that we'll leave it there.
But I really want you guys out there, write into us and tell us about your passions.
Yes.
And your purpose. It would be really interesting to know.
It would be interesting if all of our, like, 100,000 people just write to us and say, this is my passion, and this is my purpose. And then we can, like, group them together, and there'll be, like, a little survey. And we can say, like, so 35% of our listeners who have written into us say that their passion is flower arrangement.
Wow.
Like, wow, you really don't have much of life. No, I'm just kidding, though.
Hey, and then their purpose would be saving the planet.
No, the purpose would be flourish.
It could be. Yeah. It could be that your passion is also really closely connected to your purpose.
Sometimes it is. But it doesn't necessarily have to be so.
No.
And I think that maybe for younger people, so some of our younger listeners who have a hard time figuring out both passion and purpose. Because there's so many things you can choose from. And there's so many things you can do. And you could actually become paralyzed because there's so many choices.
Yeah.
So
and some people even don't have the choices, because if you live in a country where things are really restricted.
Oh yeah.
Maybe you can't, like, maybe either you never find out your passion, or you're not able to do your purpose. Because of government, because of financial situations, because of your physical abilities. So we're talking about from our perspective.
Yeah. But we do want to hear from our listeners, and we want, and when you write about your passion, just like a couple of sentences, you know, just to give us an idea of the context,
like how
for your
you
passion
got there.
And your purpose. Yeah, like how did you arrive at this? What makes you know that this is your purpose or passion? So
it's really fun, guys. Please let us know.
Yeah, we like to hear from you, and for everyone out there, if you haven't found your purpose or passion, you give us money, we'll help you find it.
No.
Yes, we will.
I think things need also time. People don't get to be upset.
No, don't rush it, because you won't find it.
No, don't push it.
It's like the key that you lose in the house. As long as you're running around like a crazy person looking for it, you can't find it. But the moment you just relax and say, okay, I just don't know where my key is, boop, it just appears from nowhere.
Yeah.
in your back pocket.
And you were always thinking, hey, what's rattling when I'm going around exactly. trying to find my key?
You're like, well, it can't be here and it can't be there. And you're like, your keys were like, stupid.
So, guys, thank you for listening. And please write into us about please. Your passions and purposes. Yay. Thank you.
Thank you. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you for listening. If you have any comments or ideas, please send us a message to fikaforlife@mail.com. Fika, F-I-K-A. This was the Fika for Life podcast with Linh Nguyen and Edward Thomas, and we hope to hear you again.